Hi guys, thank you so much for joining us on Bloomberg Quint Live. I'm Alex Matthew and this is Portfolio. The star of today's program is Hardev Singh Rajput and he's joining us from Bengaluru. Thanks so much for joining us, Hardev.
Thank you, Alex.
All right. Now, Hardev has written to us and he said that his plan is to set aside as much as 2 crore by 2033. He's got a lot of time to plan that. He's got 15 years. And the person who's going to help him out with this plan and to tell him how to go about it is Karthik Jhaveri, who is the director at Transcend Consulting. Thank you so much, Karthik.
My pleasure.
All right. So I'm going to set both of you together. First of all, Hardev, I just want to understand from you, why 2 crore? What is the amount relating to?
No, actually, that is the lump sum amount I was planning to have because I'm working in a private limited. So I have 5 years of experience and after 20, if I have that much amount, I can start some startup or some business. And that means I'll be the financially strong at that time. If I'll have that much money, if I'll plan from now onward.
No, that's a perfectly good assessment. And you have made some investments already. You've started investments, right?
Yeah, actually in this mutual fund and stock, I came last year only. And previously I was investing in this PPF for tax saving purpose and some FDs. But since last year I have invested in some ELSS.
Okay.
And this year onward I'm planning. Yeah, no, this is not for tax saving. This is for purely for investment purpose savings.
I can see that you're taking small little baby steps towards your journey into investing into the stock market, investing through mutual funds, through SIP route and all of that. And which is quite understandably so because you have started investing about 25,000 rupees a month. And great idea that you have in your mind to build a little bit of a kitty of about 2 crores to start up something. And Bangalore is the place where, you know, hundreds and hundreds of startups happen. So I think it's in the air that everybody wants to start up a new company. And we should all be investing our money into your companies. I mean, you know, so that's the reason we are very happy when you all of you, you know, kids think about investing into and creating corpuses to invest into your own companies. So the good news is this, that you're already doing 25,000. All you have to do is just up it to about 35,000. Now, once you up it to 35,000, it's just a 10,000 more.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you were saying?
No, actually, I'm doing 50K per month and 25K I'm doing in my company only in which I'm working because I know that company very well. I know the colleagues and how the business model is and how they are working. So 25K every month I'm putting in that.
Super. Fantastic. So you're already doing that. And if you're putting in 50,000, then I mean, I was only going to ask you to do 10,000 more and you would have reached your 2 crore target in the next 15 years or so. In fact, I want to take you one more step. If you're already doing 50 and I was just doing the mathematics based on your monthly expenditure and your income and all of that. So I almost worked out that you have as much as 80,000 rupees available. And in the next 5 years, instead of 2 crores, you're going to have a possibility of 5 crores. And now that you're saying that you're already doing
15 years.
In 15 years, he's going to have about as much as about 5 crores of corpus. So you will have a much larger corpus if you like, and from which you can start up your own company and you can maybe start 2 different ventures, you can partner with somebody, I mean, you can hire people. There's going to be all that possibility which is available for you. So I think there is nothing that you need to worry. 15 years is a fair amount of time that you've got. You're doing the right thing. You need to build your confidence a little bit more. And once you start doing that, you will actually start enjoying this whole process of investing into mutual funds, SIPs, because you'll see profits coming in. You know, profits take time to come. Sometimes they come faster. Sometimes they come after a couple of years, but they'll come.
So Hardev, from what I can tell as of now, you're currently investing half of your salary, you know, both towards the company that you're currently working in and also the investments that you have on a monthly basis. You would like to keep that proportions the similar, and I'm assuming that obviously your salary is going to grow over a period of time. You're only 28 right now.
Correct. Yes. Yes.
All right. So I think that is something that we have to factor in as well, Karthik.
Indeed, you know, there's always a little bit of advantage. See, when you're young and when you've got more disposable amount of money, go max out. Don't compromise on your expenditure, but go max out. Try and invest the maximum that you can, because in future, even while the income goes up, there are expenses also which jump up. But try and invest the maximum that you can, basically make hay while the sun is shining for you. So right now, if you can invest 60, 70, 80, just go ahead and do it, because it's only going to help you in future years, not only for this but for various other things. Mm-hmm. So what we are saying is, you're 50, 60, 70 right now, next year you get a bonus, you get an increment, and all of those things can just accumulate and become a huge amount of money. Who knows, maybe you'll even land up with a, you know, 8 or 10 crores by the time you're 43, which is your target year of 2033.
Yeah, so what should be the ideal portfolio size? I mean, how many mutual funds should I have in my portfolio for having 25,000 investment?
Okay, so it's not about, are there 25,000 or 50,000 or 2 lakhs. The idea is that we need to diversify and spread our money across 3 or 4 different ideas. So one idea, for example, is say blue chips. You can have 2 schemes there. So two different companies and 2 different companies offering a blue chip, or what is known as a large cap kind of a fund. Then you have 1 mid cap fund and 1 small cap fund. Again, it could be from different companies. So you know what we are doing here is, we are diversifying your money across different ideas. We are also diversifying your team management, or the team that is managing your money. We are also going to different companies. So management style is different, management techniques are different, fund management strategies are different, and you get the advantage of everything. And then we pick up another 2 sectoral plays, you know, sectoral ideas, something like an FMCG, something like a technology, infrastructure, pharmaceuticals, these banking, these are all various ideas. So we pick up 2 of them. A safe bet is a pharmaceutical one, and a pharmaceutical one along with a FMCG, because these are sectors which are perpetually in requirement. So even if you have these 6 different ideas that you're going ahead with, then that's more than sufficient to have a very powerful portfolio, whether you're investing 50,000 or you're investing 5 lakh rupees a month.
So you're saying that I can have 6 mutual funds in that portfolio?
Absolutely, yes, yes. You can go ahead with 6 schemes, 6 different portfolios, and you can go with 6 completely different companies. So you get the advantage of the fund management strategy of various companies as well. You can even choose to be with the same 2 or 3 schemes in the same company, even that's not a problem. But if you spread yourself across, then it's nicer that way.
So no debt in his portfolio?
Absolutely not recommended, you know, because he's young, he's got a lot of time on his hand, and this is the time to make money, right, for him, because he's got no other additional responsibility. His parents are there, but like you said, parents are also independent. So at the moment, all the money is available. Let's put it to equities, and then over a period of time, we will recalibrate.
Apart from this investment, actually, I'm planning to start one small SIP, 1,000 rupees per month, just for some donation kind of. So what is the good sector for this? That is also a 10-year, I have a goal for the 10-year. So after that 10-year, I can donate that money, I can give it to someone needy person. It's not for my savings or anything.
If I may ask, Hardev, do you have something in mind with regard to what you want to give this money for?
I am from a rural area, and I have a plan to donate it for some needy poor people for their education purpose. Maybe I can sponsor 2-3 guys from my village for education purpose from that.
That's an absolutely lovely thought, Hardev, and I'm sure that Karthik will have a solution for you. Karthik?
Yeah, so, the way to differentiate this is, we start up a new fund, we start up a new investment. You can do this in a multi-cap fund because it gets the flavor of everything. It has a little bit of large cap also, it's got some mid caps also. It's got a combination portfolio. So when we are faced with a situation where there is no specific objective and we have a limited amount of money and we want to have a limited purpose for which we want to do that. So in that case, you can even use this multi-cap fund. It's a interesting idea that you can consider. Pick up a multi-cap fund and, in your own method, whether it's an Excel that you are monitoring this or whether it's a technology that you've bought, these days it's very, available at a very low cost. It's quite cheap to enroll into some technology to monitor your investments. So if you do that, you can even label that particular investment that this is for charity, this is my charity fund, and let the name of the investment be XYZ company, whatever it is, but you can call it charity fund, and that way you'll be able to differentiate it, identify it, and just open up a new fund, because you don't know when you're going to give this money, so there is no limitation of time frame, but it's a specific idea. So let's go for a multi-cap fund.
Thanks so much for joining us on this show, and especially with that lovely thought of setting aside a certain amount of money for the charity that you've got planned. Well, Karthik, thank you for helping Hardev out.
My pleasure, as always.
And to you who've tuned into this episode of Portfolio, it's quite possible that you've taken something from this conversation that can help you. A quick reminder, if you'd like to participate in our show, do write in to us on portfolio@bloombergquint.com. Thanks so much for watching. This is Bloomberg Quint.
The conversation and advice dispensed by the financial advisors on Bloomberg Quint's television show Portfolio aims at giving the guests on the show a broad approach toward their finances. The advice is not a full financial plan. Viewers are advised to work with a financial planner for specific products, choice and execution when making an independent decision regarding investments or acting on any advice. Any calculated projections or any predictions given on Bloomberg Quint's platform during the show are not guaranteed and are merely an expression of opinion and are not intended for other than illustration purposes only. No view mentioned on the program is personal advice to anyone. Bloomberg Quint is not responsible for any risk or loss that might occur as a result of placing this information into action in any way and regardless of your interpretation of the advice.